Hey, so good morning, everyone. If we were in Switzerland, I should have started 25 seconds ago. You think I'm joking. A friend of mine works for works on a Swiss development team, and we live in Germany, and this friend is my office mate. They have a stand-up at 9 o'clock in the morning, okay? 9 a.m. stand-up. Good. And so, being, you know, German cultured about this, he fires up his hangout, he gets everything going, 5 to 9, 8:55, he's ready, he's in the meeting. Okay, we're going to do our stand-up today. Let's do the stand-up. He's been working for them for 2 or 3 months, and he has his first, like, quarterly review with his supervisor. And, like, we're very, very concerned about your punctuality. You're really going to have to work on that. And he's like, oh, my God. But I've been, meh. What is, and he's thinking, like, he doesn't know what he can do more, right? And they're like, when we say it's a 9 o'clock meeting, the meeting starts at 9 o'clock. We don't want to see you in there earlier. The Swiss are really, really excitingly weird about time. So, good morning, everyone. Who's at your first DrupalCon? Okay, good targeting. And who's at your first Drupal community event at all? Wow, welcome. That's cool. You're starting right at the top. It's all downhill from here. And how many of you are involved in other open source software that's not Drupal? Do you write Symfony? Do you write straight PHP? No, JavaScript, anything? Shout out what you do that's not Drupal. Symfony, cool. JavaScript? Yeah, lots of JavaScript. Well, we need it nowadays, right? So, I'm going to go through a few slides. I want to keep this really informal. I'm going to go through a few slides, just talk about me, one of my favorite topics, and then why I think I can help you with DrupalCon. Then we're going to go through a few pages of the website, and then I really want to know what you're here for. If you want to think of something to say later, why are you here? What is it that you hope to get out of DrupalCon this week? And what is it that you need to know to make that happen? And we're going to see if we can find out, figure out solutions for all of that, okay? So, using the power of Apple, which is not open source. Yes. So, everybody calls me Jam. I am a partner at a company called Open Strategy Partners. We incorporated 3 or 4 weeks ago, I think. So that's fun. And Open Strategy Partners, we do strategy and communication, so marketing strategy and communications for companies and organizations involved in open source. And it's really, really, really fun so far. We've got a couple clients, and it's good times. I'm doing this because I was a big part of my experience. I started Drupal in 2005. I was the 18th employee at Acquia, and I left Acquia this year at around 800 employees. So I have lived through massive startup growth, building a business based on open source, all of that sort of thing. So my real passion is figuring out this amazing space between lots of hard work and contribution that we share with each other and creating value, creating business value for ourselves, creating stuff for our clients. And that's what we're really interested in. And if you want to talk about anything related to business value of contribution, open source and business, all that kind of stuff, come talk with us. That's my business partner, Tracy. Wave, Tracy. Hi. So I love coming to Drupal events because I get to hang out with superheroes. That's Addison Berry, who's on the Drupal Association board right now. Really, really long-term contributor of the project. She runs Drupalize Me, the video training service. She's the CEO of that. My first DrupalCon was at DrupalCon Brussels in 2006, and the registration process for DrupalCon Brussels was walk in the door, hand Dries a 20-euro note, and get a t-shirt. And there were about 220 of us there. It wasn't the first DrupalCon ever. It was maybe the third or the fourth Drupal event. But think about it. DrupalCon was 200 people. So organizing the social evening, a guy would just kind of stand up on the table and yell, okay, everybody, tonight we're going to this bar and that restaurant. Drupal was different. I think this is my 21st DrupalCon. In the last 5 years, I've given more than 100 presentations, dozens of keynotes, and as I said, I moved through the worlds of open source PHP business, and yeah, I really, really like that kind of thing. That was most of DrupalCon in 2006, and so this is what the Drupal community looked like at that point. That guy's me. I'm still doing Drupal. Here's Angie Byron, Webchick. There's Morton DK. I'd say about half of this picture is still in Drupal, actually, which is pretty interesting. Chicks, Merlin of Chaos, where that says that's Earl Miles who created Views. Let's see. Oh, see this? Shartan, that name there, Shartan? He actually created the first version of Drupal.org, and he was user one, and then Dries and he swapped so that Dries could have the super user account on the website. Moshe Weitzman is in the back there. Moshe is here now. Moshe is the creator of Organic Groups and Rush, and he's still involved in Drupal. And there's a ton of other people, really interesting people who are there. How young we all were. It's an embarrassingly long time ago. That was me at my first DrupalCon. Information overload is a thing, okay? And one of the things I want you to go to as many sessions as you think are going to be useful to you. And if you're not sure, maybe go and listen to it. But if it doesn't work for you, just stand up quietly and leave. It's okay. It's allowed in open source. It's called voting with your feet. Go and find something that's more valuable to you. But it's really important not to choose a session in every single slot of the day, okay? Because that's what's going to happen to you before you even get to the party, okay? And it's really, really, really important to meet people. So I don't know, who was here for the pre-note this morning, that crazy, hey, wow, thank you for coming. So that fun, weird, what does that have to do with Drupal thing? That's really important to us because... so many Drupalists are musicians or scientists or, you know, they're qualified as kindergartners or like you'd never know who you're going to meet. And everyone here is an expert. Everyone here you can learn something from. That man, for example, is an exceptional executive coach and elite athlete trainer, right? Who would have known unless, you know, you walked up and talked with him? So it's really important when you get in a big crowded room and you're not just sitting with your friends, introduce yourself to the person you're with. Go find a table at lunch where you're not sitting with people you know and introduce yourself to everyone. Find out what they do. I've made years-long friendships using that and business partners and found gigs and deals and all sorts of things. Go meet the people. We have this concept of the hallway track. Spend time in the coffee break. Just make sure that you meet new people and you take home new friendships after this week. That's really, really a really important part of what we do. This was DrupalCon Szeged. It's a bit bigger. That's 2008. This is Austin, DrupalCon Austin. That's a really big crowd. That's right after the pre-note. There's Campbell, you see, and me. And that's about 3,000 people right there. And that's an old sales pitch that we like to use in Drupal. Say, you know, when you hire me, you know, you're two-man, you're 10-person, you're one-woman Drupal shop, you know, this is... 10% of your developer pool, right? Not even 10%. Like, you're hiring all these people when you hire us. Open source is really, really powerful that way. And we're part of much more than just, you know, just Drupal. All of PHP and the fact that we use Composer, that we use Symfony components, all of this, we have massive extended communities. So please don't make this your last open source event and go to other communities, meet other communities as well, and then do the same thing. Teach them the Drupal hug. There's a photo from DrupalCon Portland. There were also an enormous number of people there. So I said it was going to be quick and informal. Those were my slides. I'm really, really interested to know who you are, what you do, and what you want to get out of the day here. I can go through a couple of tips and tricks about getting through the con, and then are you ready to ask me some questions after that? Maybe? Okay. So. Let's have a look here. Let's go to my browser. Oh, you can't see that. Ha ha. Sorry. Scroll. Ah, very good. So, driving remote. Here we are. Program. Right, so every day has a bunch of sessions and a bunch of other things going on. Who does not know what a birds of a feather session is? Birds of a feather sessions are really interesting and important. So there's a saying in English, birds of a feather flock together. So maybe you really need to figure out new solutions to use, you know, technology in education, or maybe you want to know how to run a club website, or maybe you're excited about that incredibly new JavaScript library that everyone, you know, is puzzling about, and you want to talk with other people about it. You can go, there's a Birds of a Feather page on the website, and you can look at the schedule there, and if there are slots there, you can put in your own discussion group. And it's not for making presentations, it's not for sending stuff, but you can say, we need to talk about the community in Bulgaria, or we need whatever it is you want, and Birds of a Feather, people with common interest, you can come and talk with your peers and talk about that. And it's a great tool for planning local camps, for meeting people from your region, for discussing language issues in your translation, whatever it is that you need out of Drupal, that's a great option. Birds of a Feather, they're really, really interesting and important. Every evening, there are also, let's see if it's on here, every evening there are social events, and the social events are pretty important. In Drupal as well. Let me mirror my screen so that I can see what you're seeing at the same time. Let's play. Okay. It's thinking about it. All right. Okay. Awesome. Wow, it's incredibly tiny. I need my glasses now. Let's see. Every evening there are social events, and just like you should introduce yourself to new people every day at lunch, at the other sessions, tonight there is the DrupalCon official community party put on by the Austrian Drupal Association, and it's going to be they're calling it a Viennese ball, but there's going to be, you know, wear what you want, there's going to be snacks, I believe, there's going to be music, and it's going to be a great place to just hang out and meet people from here. Wednesday, Women in Drupal is always a great event, and there's a bunch of other events. I assume that most of us are probably not invited to the DrupalCon CEO dinner, but it's here on the schedule. And Thursday, there's an interesting new event, the Drupal Marketing Sprint. I'm going to be checking that out for sure. That's a new thing to Drupal. And the single best and most important event of DrupalCon is Thursday night trivia night. This is where the community comes out for blood. And because it's your first DrupalCon, any team that you go on gets bonus points for you being on the team. So you have a valuable contribution to make at Trivia Night, and there's always good drinks there. So I find that's a real motivation. Yeah, I know. So lots of sessions to choose from, lots of session tracks to choose from. Open source software comes from our contributions, right? Obviously code, also community organizing, writing documentation, doing translations, running great businesses, right? Telling your friends about it, that's all contributions to open source. But we have these sprints, and a code sprint is where people come together to solve technical problems together. And the community aspect of this is really important. We're a community who works remotely with each other for 50 weeks of the year. And as we know online, there can be real problems with trolling, real problems with people attacking each other. And once you've met someone in person, looked them in the eye, had a beer with them, had a conversation with them, worked on a patch together, right, you have an actual relationship with that person. You remember what she looks like, you remember how he talks. And contribution with someone you've met in person, that there's an actual relationship there, and the remote work is lubricated. It goes better. You know, you have an actual person in your mind, and it really, really helps to remember that when we're looking at the issue queues, when we're looking on Twitter, in this time of deep discontent in our community and extreme politics around the world and so on, you really, really have to remember that the people behind those words on the screen, they're also people, right? And somebody just lost their job, somebody just had a kid, somebody's struggling to pay the bills, somebody's learning, somebody knows more than you, somebody knows less than you. We have to keep in mind that we're human, and working together in person is a great opportunity to really, you know, get a taste of the human side of our project. If you've never done a code sprint before, and even if you only have limited coding abilities, there are new contributor sprints, and they're mentored, and there's a page on here to say what you need to do to prepare and get ready for that, and there's a whole special room with special mentors on Friday set up for first-time contributors, new contributors. They will help you get your machine set up. They will help you look for good issues. They will tell you how the process works. It's a fantastic tradition in the Drupal community. The onboarding and mentoring that those people do is fantastic. And if you really, really want to get excited about Drupal, write a patch that gets accepted into Drupal. Like, maybe you just fix a word describing how one of the interfaces works, like, but your patch, right? Your work, once it's gone through the process, that gets downloaded 300, 400,000 times a month. Like, the feeling of ownership once a piece of your code, like, you typed and that's being used everywhere, it's amazing, right? And then the project is a little bit yours. And you're a little bit more, you know, sucked into the black, beautiful black hole that is Drupal. So I highly recommend checking out the sprints if you're inclined at all to write code. There are plenty of other ways to contribute. And a contribution is another of the things that I think about a lot in my work. I wrote a blog post last spring about attending your first DrupalCon, and I'll just see about the highlights there. What clever things I said. I said come to the pre-note. Most of you got that. Thank you. I said come to the Dries note. I think probably most of you stayed for that too. Come to this session. You're doing very well on that front. Remember to drink water, right? And if you go to an American con and it's the summer, and I'm just, of course, this is completely irrelevant now, but the way the Americans manage their buildings, if it's the summer, bring a sweater with you because it's going to be freezing inside the building. It's absolutely awful how they do that. Bring some business cards. Don't forget to introduce yourself to people and talk with them. If you haven't decided what you're going to go and see, it would be really worth sitting down in the break and getting an idea of what you really want to see so that you're not sort of panicking at the last minute and losing time trying to figure out what you should do next. There's a DrupalCon app on the Play Store and the whatever the Apple one is. That can be pretty helpful. Let me see. Dun, 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 ba-dum. Oh, yeah, Drupal loves social media. So if you're on Twitter and you use at DrupalCon EUR, for example, or I am at Horn Cologne, Drupal loves Twitter. Drupal's pretty active on Facebook too. Get to, you know, join in on social media. That's a really, really good thing to do too. Told you about sprints already. And then after DrupalCon, I hope that you'll feel more part of the community and more, and you know, ready to spread the word and participate even more the next time. I would say that is absolutely everything that I have to say of a formal nature, and it would be a privilege for me to get to know any of you who want to, you know, share something now, and like I said, I'd be really, really curious to know why you came here, what you want to get out of DrupalCon, and then all the questions that you might have, like what you feel might, you know, what information you need to make those things happen. Who wants to start? Andreas, why are you at DrupalCon?
Yeah, for me, it's the first time. And in fact, I see that I'm not the youngest here. And I'm always like to be with young people, like young and very dynamic and engaged people. And I'm looking forward to to change some perspective. Their people and everybody.
Thank you. Awesome. Do you want to come up here and put say it into here so that it's recorded and then we'll have a conversation? Fantastic.
I'd like to know, why are you here and what do you want to get out of?
Hey guys and girls. I'm Ben. I'm recently a developer after changing from project management. And basically just interested in learning a lot more about Drupal. I've been at a Drupal agency for about 6 months now, but it's still fairly behemothic to me at the moment. So,
nice adjective.
I'm basically just trying to get a greater understanding of all of sections of Drupal, both front end and back end, and even the business side of things. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
And so you're gonna do technical sessions?
Yeah, I mean, that was going to be one of my questions, really, was, like, do you have any recommendations in terms of, like, balancing sessions, either towards, like, let's say, your strengths, because right now I'm far more front-end, but equally, like, a lot of the back-end stuff interests me a lot, but I feel at the same time, you know, I see the sort of, like, difficulty ratings or whatever, or the session recommendations, but I'm not sure how intermediate is, because some things I read which are intermediate, I'm like, oh, I know that, and some I'm like, that for me is, you know, next level advanced stuff.
Yeah, that's a little tricky. I think it comes down to how the description is written, right? And whether, and also, you know, whether you just want to go in there and give it a go for 5 minutes. Mm. But I would say that if you are working mostly in the front end, right, then you have an opportunity to share what you know when you go to sessions like that. But if you're really trying to move your career towards the back end, right, then maybe you should pick like 3 things that you think you really need to know about in the next 6 months and not only go to that session, but then talk with the person who gave the session, right? Because once you know them, you can get on IRC or Slack or wherever with them and you know, you might have a great resource to pull you along further.
Sure. Cool. Awesome. Thanks.
Anyone else? It would be cool if you could do it into the microphone because, you know, then we'd have this recorded for posterity. Everybody's very, very shy today. All right.
Where do you live, Ben?
I live in London right now.
Okay.
From New Zealand.
I went to Wellington.
Oh, really? Yeah.
I know you can't hear it.
Awesome.
So, Matthias. Matthias Nielsen, where are you from?
I'm from Denmark.
You're from Denmark.
And I work at a small software company. We've kind of, it's only me and my boss out of 7 employees who use Drupal, and that's kind of why they've invested in sending me here to learn more about it.
Cool, and what do you need to bring back your boss to make this week a success?
Pretty much like general overall knowledge, because it's me who has to kind of take over most of the Drupal side stuff once he's ready.
Okay, so that's simple. You just have to learn about all of Drupal in the next 3 days.
Yeah.
And what do you want to get out of the weekend?
Probably mostly backend stuff, because I need to do a lot of backing up stuff, generally.
And you from Copenhagen?
I'm from a small island called Falster, but yeah, I work in Copenhagen.
Because there's a ton of great Drupal and Drupalists in Copenhagen. Do you go to the user scene, the meetups and stuff?
I'm going to after... Mm. Because they want to send me there, too.
Okay, fantastic. So not only are there a bunch of great companies and really great community members up there, there's a ton of people that you could and should meet. You should maybe especially look for a woman called Camilla Janssen, I guess? Anyway, her username is Naxoc, N-A-X-O-C, and she's about this tall and Danish, and she lives in Copenhagen. And she's Addison Berry's wife. And Addison Berry also lives in Copenhagen. And I know that they're here this time. If you go introduce yourself to Camilla, that'd be a great resource to like to meet more people in Copenhagen. And have you met Morten DK?
No, but I'm going to the Danish meetup.
You're going to the Danish meetup. All right. Vikings rule. Good plan. Okay. Who's next? You sat on the right side of the room, so... Giles, where are you from, Giles?
I'm from London.
You're from London.
I am, yes, but I live in Berlin these days and I work there. And I'm being terribly rude and sitting here and doing some work while you're talking. I was listening the whole time, but unfortunately needs must.
Well, no, I mean, that's multitasking is our reality, right?
I really don't like multitasking. I'm a single track kind of a guy and it's just not...
Yeah, I know. It's Facebook,
Stack...
It's something I'm
trying to give away. I don't want to be doing social media management anymore. I want to concentrate on Drupal, which is one of the reasons I'm here, and one of the reasons I'm quite annoyed at being distracted.
Fantastic. So what is it that you need to get out of this week, and how can we help you?
Everything. In every way.
All right. So are you looking for more technical stuff, or?
Yeah, I mean, I'm more of a back-end person, and so I'm more looking into Drupal 8, which I haven't really started much developing yet. So, you know, I've done some Drupal 7 development, which is okay for my level of PHP, but I now am one of those people who needs to learn OOP. Mm-hmm. So.
Object-oriented, yep. Yep, so there's a bunch of,
For me.
Okay, but let's talk about OOP. there's a what you get with Drupal 8. Once you get there, you know there's a lot more files. There's a lot more depth to the tree, right?
I'm not averse to that.
Right. Right. It's all gonna be fine. And what's awesome? And I'll tell you one awesome thing with Drupal 7. Like once you got really, really fluent with Drupal 7, you spent a weekend to learn one internal system, and a weekend to learn another internal system, and another week to learn another, and there are 21, 22 of them, and they each have their own, you know, incredibly idiosyncratic ways of working, right? Now in Drupal 8, thanks to OOP and like ripping and replacing so many things, every internal system has unified the same CRUD operations, and you only need to learn each of their specialties. So you learn one system, and you've learned like 80% of the whole thing. Right, so once you're there, like there's a steep little thing, but then there's a really, really nice plateau. Awesome. Berlin, cool town, except we have to officially hate it because all our friends are moving there from Cologne right now. But if you come down to Cologne, look me up. Okay, all right. So, someone in the middle of the room.
No? What's your name?
Alvaro.
Alvaro, where are you from?
I'm from Spain.
From where?
Valencia.
Valencia?
But I live in Norway.
Wow.
I can tell by your incredible Norwegian accent. So are you doing Drupal up in Norway?
Yeah, I work at a company, and we work with newspapers from Scandinavia.
There's a Drupal really dominates that landscape, right?
Yes.
So I'm sorry if this is personal, but has that helped you be more mobile in your career? Like, I know that the Spanish economy hasn't, you know, been the greatest. Is that part of why you're in Norway?
No, it's basically the company, I would say.
So, what are you here for in Vienna?
Well, my company is quite spread out, so we reunite here, also to learn more from each other.
So that whole remote story that I was saying, that counts for your company as well. Like, you have a sort of a team building exercise at DrupalCon as well. All right, and what do you need to know to make your week a success?
I've been developing Drupal for 1 year, and yeah, I really want to learn more about the Drupal community, especially.
Fantastic. I really, really highly recommend checking out the sprints in your case, because as a coder and a relatively new one and trying to get into the community, you're going to meet really the right sort of people to just keep this going in the right way. Matthias, René, Niklas, where are you guys from? Brainbits. Oh, wait a minute, Cologne. Aren't you from Bonn, technically? No? Hey, so, Olaf. No. Oh, okay, all right. We have friends in Düsseldorf, too. What are you guys here for this week?
In our company, we are building a new Drupal 8 development team, and so our boss wants us to get the knowledge from here and how we can acquire that.
And what's your focus this week?
I think it's front end. I'm a front end developer, and I put a lot of talks and courses, workshops on my schedule. So,
right. Yeah. He's gonna do the hard work. you guys are going to focus on the beer drinking. I have this.
I think I'm going to end up like you. Great.
So that's cool. I don't think I knew that BrainBits was in Cologne, and that's really good news. Let's hang out when we're back home. We have our office on Hansaring, so. Okay, fantastic. Let's make sure. Okay, so hey, so we're doing live community building here. I just got connected back to the local user group where I'm supposed to be already. So shame on me, I think. Who else has a problem or a question where they're not sure how to get something, meet someone, learn something this week? You. Thank you very much. Hi, Karim.
Yes.
Where are you from?
From Mainz.
From Mainz?
I work in Wiesbaden, but I'm living in Mainz.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
A lot of Germans in the room today.
Yes.
So.
Yeah, I work in the public sector, and we are maintaining several Drupal 7 instances.
Yes.
And we have the challenge to migrate to Drupal 8, so that's we want to learn about. And also figuring out how to automate tests to improve security and also to automate the upgrading process be a little bit quicker.
Cool. So on Thursday, you have to look at the schedule, Sebastian Bergmann is going to be at DrupalCon, and he's the maintainer of PHP Unit. And he's going to be talking about testing, obviously, and so that's a great, great person to hang out with. And if he's got time to be at the sprints, I know he wanted to spend time at the sprints talking about testing with people who needed help. So Sebastian Bergmann is going to be here, and that's a great place to start for that stuff. If you want to look at migration stuff, my office mate is really good at that, but he's leaving. He can't stay at the con all week. But he's in Cologne, and if you get in touch, I can introduce you. But there's like a fundamental question too. You know, Drupal 7 is still supported, right? It's still got security patches. Why is it that you need to upgrade to Drupal 8, and what's the timeline?
I think it's related to the elections in Hesse. So it's the elections are in 2018. So after that, we will probably need new completely new sites, because there will be a new government and they want to represent themselves. That's the timeline, but we want to learn about it and maybe try it out sure. During the next year to gather some experience and yeah.
Okay, so that's actually a really great excuse just so like, let's build a new site anyway.
Yeah.
So you're looking more at maybe data migration, so you may be building a new application and then moving the data into it?
Yeah, because I think there's no easy or common way to migrate the content. So probably we have to build some tool for ourselves to migrate the content. I'm not sure about that, but
I think the good news is Dries was saying, who was paying attention to Dries' note today? What did he say about the migration path? 12 critical bugs. Okay, so that's something to contribute to in the sprints this week. But the concept with Drupal 8 was to, you're never going to do another upgrade, right? We're going to build a new application and we're going to migrate into it. Then the future thing with the double APIs down the road is going to make that it's future music, as we say in German. But it sounds like if you look into the area of migration now and look at the migration tools and look at the migration path, that would be a great place to learn. And it would be a great place to contribute, because you're going to be contributing straight into what you need to do at work with 6 months, 8 months from now, right? Mm-hmm. So you should find, there are always sprints going on, right? And if you have time in between the sessions, go find someone who's running the sprint room. They'll have like a special t-shirt or something. And start asking them who is working on the migration path and that you'd like to learn more and that you'd like to help. And they will take you straight to the right people who are doing that. And then you will help us and help yourself at work next year. Is it a plan?
Good.
All right.
Thank
cool.
you very much.
And if you come to Cologne, come ping me, we'll do a beer. or more than one, because they're small in Cologne. Hey, okay, so that feels like progress. Who else needs something? Do you need something? Do you mind coming across the room? I'm sorry, they don't have credit cards or wireless mics in Austria. Hi, I'm Jam.
Maciek.
Maciek, nice to meet you.
Yeah.
Are you from the Czech Republic?
No.
Are you from Slovakia?
No.
Wait a minute. Wait. Okay, where are you from?
No.
You're from Poland?
Yes.
We were just in Poland. Our friend Adam from the Prenote, the guy with the black curly hair, he just got married in Warsaw.
Yes?
Yeah. Oh, it's fantastic. I love Polish food. Sorry. Okay, so it's getting a little late here. So Maciek, mm-hmm. What do you do with Drupal?
Well, I would like to be more engaged in community because I'm developing Drupal in the last 10 years, maybe 9. But my commitment in community was quite small, so now I think I want to more engage and see how I can do that.
Fantastic. So are you a developer?
Yes. I'm a backend developer, but also can do work on frontend. It's not a problem. But mainly I'm working in backend. Now for Flemish government, we are providing some Drupal solutions. So
Nice. The Flemish government has a huge installation.
Yes.
And it's been around for a long time, so I imagine it needs some upgrades and stuff too.
Yes. we did first migrations last year, so to Drupal 8.
To Drupal 8, oh nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
And now we are preparing next ones. So.
And when you say you want to contribute more and be more part of the community, what is it that you want to do? More code patches? More?
Yes, also more code patches, but also initiatives related to UX, etc. So I'm open now. Actually, I'm here to search something for me.
Okay, so cool. So go check out the sprint rooms because they will tell you absolutely everything you need to know about contributing more code. And there is a guy here called Roy Scholten, and he's the newest core maintainer, and he's the UX lead for core. And if you want to work on that kind of stuff, go meet him. He's Dutch. He's about that tall. And his username is Yoroy, Y-O-R-O-Y. Find Yoroy, ask him, like, tell him you're interested, see, and just, find out who he tells you to talk with, what he tells you to look at. And that'll be a really good, like, if you start at the top, then it'll be hard to go wrong with that.
Okay.
Cool. Hey, great. Thanks for coming to DrupalCon. All right. Now, we have 20 minutes that we can talk as much as we want. I propose, depending on how you feel about this, we can wrap up for maybe 5 minutes and then get to our break a little earlier, have some more coffee. How are we feeling? More like 5 minutes? More like 20 minutes? More like 5 minutes? I was trying to get you there. Thank you, Jaz. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, so would you like to tell us what you need to get out of DrupalCon this week? Yes, you in the orange jacket. Hi, I'm Jam.
Hey, I'm Anu.
Anu, very nice to meet you. Where are you from?
Finland.
Finland,
yeah.
And you work with
Siili Solutions, not Siili. Siili is hedgehog in Finnish.
It's hedgehog, okay.
Yes, there's Siili. A story which I won't get into now, right now.
Please tell us the hedgehog story.
Sorry, the details are a bit hazy to me. I should get better on the company strategy. But.
Because it was vodka plus sauna equals company name.
Yeah. Not so much. It's all about being agile and that kind of stuff. So,
okay.
Yeah.
So, what do you do with...
Currently, I work with maintenance of our Drupal sites, mainly Drupal 7 for the moment. And I'm looking forward to get into more D8 and prepare myself and also get smarter with the support flow workflows.
Okay, so you're looking for that sort of inspiration this week?
Yeah, maybe. And for a company, more like how do we sell Drupal? We're like 500 strong IT consultancy. 8 Drupalists, team is 8-9. And how do we sell Drupal internally or how do we promote it in Finland? how do we get ahead with that? So that's maybe another angle.
That's really interesting. So on the workflow side, I wonder if maybe project management sort of sessions wouldn't be valuable. I'm not sure. I haven't looked at all the tracks, but that might be a place to look in terms of you know, how we built. Sometimes there have been, in the past, there have been sessions for, you know, how to support 500 customers on a shoestring budget, or how to, all that sort of thing. So project management might be really interesting. And then there's a business and marketing track that has a few really, really great sessions this time. So in terms of learning how to sell and learning how to talk about it, apart from calling us up, right, and having a beer with Tracy and me here, because like that's what we live and breathe, I would check out the business track, and then I would try and balance my time between the internal advocacy problem is a really, really interesting one. So we've been talking with some organizations, very, very large organizations, who need to learn communications just to be able to sell what they're doing internally. And I'd really, really love to talk with you more about like the challenges that you face. Like, I don't know if you're competing with other technologies, or you have the PHP haters and you have the, right? I'd really, really love to explore that more with you. But I think some of the business track would be interesting, and maybe my session on the business value of contribution, and then project management stuff.
Automated testing and that kind of workflows.
Okay. If you want to do that side, yes. Yeah, also look for Sebastian Bergman, yeah. and the testing sessions. Awesome. So nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
And okay, everyone. Any more questions? Yes. Can you come over here? This just ended up being this way. Hi.
Hi.
Who are you?
I'm Silje. I'm from Norway.
Nice to meet you.
Likewise, I met you before once in Oslo at this Drupal camp. And yeah, I work in a small company called New Media, where I work as the only girl and the only designer. So I'm here like looking for some new input, mostly. And I was recommended by some of the other guys there to come here to meet people and stuff. So yeah. But I was a little bit unsure how to prioritize the sessions.
Okay.
I already got some tips from you now, like don't go to a session on every slot, like I plan to, like bam, bam, bam.
Yeah,
but,
right.
Yeah. But other than that, it's a bit difficult for me to like decide what should I prioritize.
So as a designer, how technical do you consider yourself?
Well, I've only been working with Drupal for a year. And this is also my first working place. So, yeah, beginner.
Okay.
And we've been working in Drupal 7 mostly, and now I'm kind of trying to learn Twig and stuff like that. Yeah. So, it's mostly just designing and implementing themes.
Okay. So, designing and implementing themes, that's a really good opener. Definitely learn everything about Twig that you can. And here's a really great tip for the world that we're living in Drupal 8. If you wrap your head around object-oriented PHP, Giles, if you wrap your head around Twig, if you know Symfony, right, these are all completely transferable technologies. If you were a great Drupal 7 developer, you were pretty much a great Drupal 7 developer, and the internals of Drupal 7 are so bizarre that it was really hard to apply them anywhere else. But Drupal 8's very much mainline PHP, very much in line with how people are doing things now. Twig is the theming layer for more than 100 other PHP projects. So if you know how to make a thing look beautiful and usable with Twig, your employability, your career path just opened up, you know, across, OroCommerce, PHPB, PHPBB, Easy Publish, and tons and tons and tons of other CM, like, and all sorts of e-commerce, everything in between. That's incredibly valuable for you. And this connection between visually pleasing, usable things and getting them implemented right is really, really hard for a lot of us who come from the technical back end. So if you can apply that, you can bring incredible value to all of our projects. So definitely check out anything to do with Twig. Probably the front-endy, JavaScript-y stuff. One of you guys is a front-ender, no? You, yeah, you chat with him. That Thomas? No. René, sorry. You talk with René about that part of front-end technologies, and then I think you'd be on your way to getting a lot out of the week. Yes? And don't forget to come to the parties and introduce yourself to your session neighbors. It's great to see you. Whew, all right. Anyone? Anyone? Thank you so much for coming to DrupalCon and for coming to this session. It's been really, really, really great to meet you. I'm incredibly easy to find online as Horn Cologne, and yeah. Tell me how your DrupalCon goes, okay? Thank you.
Nice to meet you.